Hey, how's it going, gentlemen? Welcome back to the 7Works channel. At the intro, I told you that I'm going to be rating both regular release and the premium Bandai, but as I keep, you know, trimming just now, and then I found out that the regular release part is already 30 minutes. So I don't want you to sit there and then watch me talking for 1 hour straight. So today, this video will be the regular release, and tomorrow, it will be the premium Bandai version. And I really hope you to watch the whole video because I spent a long time to record it and then trim it and then make it look good. It took a lot of time and then it took me a lot of effort to make this video. I really hope you watch the whole thing. And then I just want to do like a quick clarify. Everything that I said in this video is based on my personal opinion. It's just based on my knowledge. If anything goes wrong or if anything you don't agree with me, it's okay. You can point that out. And I really hope you to watch the whole video because I spent a long time making this and I actually took a long time to edit this and I put a lot of effort to make this video. It's a very long video, I gotta warn you. And I, as usual, I will put the time codes down in the description. If you're looking for a specific Gunpla, I already give you the time. You just click on it and then it will skip to that part. So make sure you subscribe and hit the bell because I took a long time to make this video and enjoy. Today, this is a very special video and it will be a long video, trust me. So today I'm gonna be going through every single real gray kits and I'm gonna rank them and then sort of like rating it and then give you some advice because in my ROG video, I often see three questions that being consistently appeared in my comment section is it worth it? Does it hold up? Should I buy it? So I will just put it in this video and just answer you everything, okay? So real gray do have a lot of gunplas and then you have to choose it and then you have to choose it carefully because real gray is pretty expensive as well. So I want you to choose the ones that is actually worth your money instead of throwing your money to the sea and then dump it into the trash. Now this one right here, I will be including the ROG regular release and the premium Bandai release as well. So make sure you stick around and watch the whole video. And I'll put the timeline down in the description. If you just want to watch the premium Bandai, I'll put the time code there and then you just skip it to there. And there you go. So, but for the premium Bandai part, I just want to say that I'll be excluding the Gundam Dog version, the Gundam Base version, and the Clear version because I don't want to be renting every single premium Bandai for 10 minutes. Anyway, I got my list open and now I got Gundam Venom open at my laptop here. Alright, I'm ready and now let's get to some rating. And here we are, the first one in the list, the RX-78 to Gundam. No, you do not buy it. Why? Because, you know, it's a very early ROG. The frame is really loose and two, the core fighter will just pop out like with a slight touch. I didn't build one of them, but I have an experience of playing with one of them in my friend's house. And when I try to, you know, pose it and then move it around, the movement is just really loose. And then sometimes the core fighter would just disconnect it from the whole Gunpla. And then, you know, your Gunpla just broke into three pieces. I do not recommend you to buy it. And also, you know, the early ROGs, they don't have the proper design on the weapons. And then they don't really give you weapon holding hands. So that's why when you try to pose with RX-78, it's really difficult. Because the weapons will either don't really stick and then your full movable hand will just kind of screwing you up. So no, don't buy the ROG version. The ROG version is a no-no because it will piss you off, trust me. Coming up next is the Saga 2 used by Char Aznabu, the 02 in the ROG line. No, you do not buy it. If you watch all three of my Saga ROG review, you know that I always been ranting on those videos talking about how the weapons have a very poor design in the handle because the handle is just a very small piece that clip into the weapon slot and then you just try to use some tools to flip it out and then you can stick it on the hands. No, you do not get those ROG Sakus. If you love Sakus, buy the Master Grey or the Origin ones because no, don't buy the ROG. The ROG one is ridiculously garbage. It cannot stand by itself. The articulation is horrible. And then the spring on the legs, the tube on the pipe thing at the legs right there, they will always pop out unless you super glue it. And then they cannot stand by itself, which I mentioned, and then their weapon is poorly designed. And speaking of that, some of the Sakus do have that weapon rack at the left shoulders for you to put on the weapons, but they do not really work well on the Saku. Yes, it's pretty stable to put all the weapons on the shield, but because the weight is too much and your Saku is gonna be, first, your Saku cannot stand itself. Now you're adding a bunch of weapons on it. It's just, the Saku is not gonna be standing. So if you're planning to purchase the ROG Saku, I won't stop you, but I already warned you that ROG Saku 2 is, in my opinion, the second worst ROG that you can get. The next ROG in the list will be L Strike Gundam. I reviewed this around 4 months ago, or 4 or 5 months ago, I don't really remember. But I do want to say that although I did say that you can buy it in that review, if you wish to enjoy this, or if you're a true fan of this, buy an MGOPG. Don't buy the ROG. ROG is, the stability is really questionable. But now, as time passes, I find out that the L Strike Gundam, one, the legs become extremely loose, and two, the hands, the arms can't even lift up now, can't even lift weapons anymore. When you just put the weapons on the arms, and it just loose as hell. It can't hold weapons anymore. So no, do not buy the L Strike Gundam. And if you really want the L Strike Gundam, you can just buy the RM version on the Master Grade. It's regular release anyway, so you can get it. If you are saying that you like the ROG, I honestly don't recommend you to buy the L Strike, because if you are trying to buy the real grade L Strike, you need to buy the Skycraft Spur as well, because the Skycraft Spur will give you the weapon holding hand for your L Strike Gundam. Otherwise, you're gonna have to use those very crappy full movable hand and then try to get your weapon in place. It's really painful, trust me. When I was trying to shoot photos of my L Strike, it took a long time because the weapon keep falling down from the full movable hand. So it's up to you. If you decide to buy it, you have to buy it with the Skygrasper as well. It will save you a lot of time. If you're not planning to buy the Skygrasper and you love the L Strike, buy the Master Grey. Don't buy the ROG, please. Now, 04 is the Saku 2. Again, all the ROG Saku you should not be purchasing. Weapon got problems. It can't stand on itself. The articulation is absolutely garbage. You do not buy any ROG Sakus. Although they look pretty nice, if you have that kind of money to buy ROG Sakus, why don't you just throw your money at Master Grey? There's no point for you to buy ROG Sakus. Just don't buy it. Okay, upcoming next, the Freedom Gundam. And I don't have one of them. I only have the HGC one and the Master Grey one, which I haven't built yet. I don't have the ROG version, so I'm not really qualified to judge it very critically or very heavily, because I don't own one of them. But from based on what I saw, based on what I researched, and I actually look at the instruction, it got the same problem just like the high grade one or the MG one. Is the standing got a bit problem because the wings is really heavy first, and then two, I can based on what I saw on the Seed Series ROG, they pretty much have pretty loose legs. So I assume that Freedom is gonna be pretty loose on the legs as well. And other than that, should you buy it or not? Honestly, it's up to you, but you have Master Grade to choose it. And then you also have the high grade version that have more stability than the real grade, because the early real grade is having a really trash stability. So if you want to get a small scale Freedom, I know it's painful, but I would recommend you to get the high grade, the HGCE one. If you want something bigger, just buy the Master Grade 2.0. The 2.0 Freedom is honestly not bad and is excellent. Okay, upcoming one is the ROG Skygrasper. Yes, you should buy this because this is probably one of the best ROG that I've seen before, and it contains the striker packs for you if you have the ROG L Strike. Again, you can buy it as individuals, or if you have the ROG L Strike, you can buy the Skygrasper as well. And other than that, I don't really have anything to say about the Skygrasper, because honestly, the Skygrasper is not that bad. 07 and the 08, the Gundam Mark II, the Titans and the Aogo version. I will recommend you to buy this, but I do want to warn you that the torso is extremely loose, because the torso, there's a ball joint there, is extremely loose from the day that you start playing with it. is already very loose. So I do want to warn you about that. But other than that, most of the joint is staying pretty fine. So yes, I would recommend you to buy it. It's just I'm telling you that the torso is extremely loose. It's literally you just poke it a little, just poke it gently, and it will move like massively. So I will tell you that the torso is extremely loose on the Mark II, no matter it's the Titans version or the Eugo version. Or if you don't know what I'm talking about, the black and white version, either of them will be just really loose on the torso. So I'm just telling you to watch out. Other than that, most of the stuff is pretty fine. So yes, you can buy it. Next one, the Justix Gundam. Again, just like the Freedom, because they use the same frame. So of course the legs is gonna be a little bit loose. I don't own one of them, so I don't want to be doing a heavy criticism on the Justix. But when I looking at the instruction and based on the research that I found, I found that because the Justix have a very famous pose where it stands on its backpack, and then when I look at the joint is actually pretty fragile, so you need to be careful when you're playing with it. Other than that, I think Justix do have the standing problem as well, because the backpack is pretty heavy. Just like the Freedom, it relies on stand, or you have to get like some very weird standing position to get a balance. So again, you can buy this, but honestly I think that you should buy the Master Grade. That the Master Grade is brand new, and this Justix right here is from like what, 2012. Why do you want to buy it? Just buy the Master Grade. Now, upcoming next is the Zeta Gundam. I do want to do some ranting about this Galva, because honestly, you shouldn't be buying this ROG. I do have one of them, but I got too pissed. I got too angry and I actually threw it on the ground and broke it, and then I just threw it into the trash. Because I don't like the ROG Zeta Gundam design. First, yes, I know in a very small scale, you try to make... Because ROG, the purpose of ROG is to give you something like the MG, so they kind of try to string down the MG design. I don't really know that, because I might be wrong. If I'm wrong, please tell me. The Zeta Gundam do have a very heavy problem. I mean, a very big problem is that the transformation, first, is not smooth, and two, the transformation, because the Galva is so small, and then when you try to push down the parts, it's just really easy to break. Everybody know that Zeta Gundam RG is the part faller. It's just falling, the parts were just falling over and over and over again when you try to transform. And the antenna is really easy to break, because it's really thin, and when you try to transform it, you need to close it up and then push down to the torso, and it's really easy to break. So I do not recommend you to buy any of the real grade Zeta Gundam. No, just don't buy it. Love the transformation, buy the perfect grade. Or you want to go low budget, the MG Zeta 2.0 is honestly not that bad. So I think you can buy the MG and the PG instead. You don't have to buy the ROG. The ROG is a waste of money. Upcoming next is the ROG Destiny Gundam. No, this is definitely a no. You do not buy this ROG. This ROG, I reviewed it a long time ago, and now the ROG is just immovable. I cannot move it, because if I move it, then basically it cannot stand, and the articulation would just become very weird. It become really loose as time passes. I do not recommend you to buy it. Plus now you have the XGCE version, where it gives you the palm cannon effect part, and it also give you the wings of light. So you don't have to purchase that very expensive expansion unit for your ROG Destiny. Don't buy the ROG version. The ROG version is honestly garbage. Upcoming next is the GP01. Both of them, you do not buy it, because this is the top, this is the number one, the champion of the worst ROG. Why? Because the Core Fighter, just like the RX-78, it would disconnect randomly after you put in the shell for a while. And two, you know, basically everything that related to Core Fighter is gonna be really garbage, because they just doesn't stick together. Okay, the pieces were just flying around and it don't stick together. So GP01, don't buy it. But honestly, I don't know what Bandai can do, because they don't revive the XG version, and now the ROG version is a mess, and then they do not make a 2.0 or 1.5 for the Master Grade as well. So I guess your only option, if you like the GP01, is Perfect Grade. I'm sorry, but Bandai is screwing with us, and they don't give us revive version. And when they give us a revive version like the ROG version, they just make it completely garbage with that Core Fighter system. ROG Strike Freedom Gundam. Honestly, I do not own one of it, so I'm not really qualified to give you opinions or give you like criticism about should you purchase it or not. Strike Freedom uses the same frame just like the Destiny. The the Destiny, the Justice, and the Freedom, I think. I think they're both using the same frame. So the legs is gonna be really loose, and plus you have so many options of strike freedom. You don't really have to stick with RG. And speaking of the scale of the RG strike freedom, it's been really questionable because not only myself think that the scale got problems, a lot of people think that the RG strike from the strike freedom Gundam got some scaling problems. So the most comfortable way that for me to build a strike freedom Gundam is actually the HGC. The HGC version, the scale looks fine, and the RG, honestly, it looks like the old high grade version. So I'm not really a fan of it, but if you want to purchase it, I'm not gonna stop you. Next up, Exia. Yes, you will need to buy this because the Exia, honestly, for a early RG, this frame looks, the frame stability is really good, and overall the finish it looks pretty nice, especially the blades were chrome plated silver. It looks really nice. The articulation is really nice as well, and also you can mess around with all those swords right there. So honestly, the Exia is, you can buy it, but the RG version of the Exia just suffered the same problem from the Master Grade as well, is the legs of the feet joint. I don't really remember, it's really loose and it's very hard for you to pose because it's pretty loose. So you just have to deal with it. But overall the finish and the frame is pretty stable, so I'll say that yes, you can buy this RG Exia. Next up is the Shar Aznebu Zogok. I don't own one of them, honestly. I cannot make criticism about it because I never built one of them. Although there's a lot of time that I try to buy it, but I end up just spending my money somewhere else. So I never get my hands on it. But based on what I saw, I'm not gonna be heavily criticism. So, but I do want to tell you that based on something that I saw and based on some reviews that I found or I've watched, it seems like the claws will eventually get loose pretty quickly after you just messing around for a week or so. So up to you. The next one will be the Wing Gundam Zero EW. Did I get it correct? Yes, okay. So keep going on. I do own one of them, and that was one of my most viewed videos. So until this day, I still recommend you to buy it. Honestly, the Wing Gundam's frame is really nice. Until this day, it's still pretty stable and you can still play with it. And if you're asking, wait, it got a big wings, so how can it stand? Actually, the wings is the part that is the best part right here, because first the wings is, you know, you can play around as articulational poses, and then it can help you as a, you know, standing support or something like that. So overall, it's not going to be looking ugly when you try to balance it with your wings as well. It's not going to be really, it's not going to look ridiculous or look really ugly. So I think that this one you can buy it. Plus, it's not really that expensive, so you can just give it a try. And the MG version is really old. It's like 2001 or 2002. I can't remember. So if you're just looking, and the high grade version is really old as well. It's from the 90s. So I would just say that if you want to get a small scale Wing Gundam, the RG is definitely a must buy. Next one, the Real Grade 00 Riser. It's really up to you because we got the MG version to choose as well. But I do want to say that, as I said about the Exia, the RG one, the legs, I can't really remember now. It's the legs or the feet? I can't remember. Either way, one of the joints will be really loose eventually, so that's the only problem. And 00 frame is pretty, the legs frame is not holding that well, so sometimes when you put on the backpack, the whole double riser will just leaning towards the back. If you don't mind that, then you can buy it, because some people do really care about how the Gunpla stand. They don't want it to be leaning front or leaning back. They want it to be perfectly at the middle, so some people just can't deal with leaning back. But I'm telling you that double riser RG, from my memory, it will lean back. So if you're okay with it, then you can go with it. Next up is the RG Astray Red Frame. Yes, you can buy this because one, the articulation is really nice, and two, the movement is pretty wide as well, so you can make some very crazy poses. And three, just like the Exia, the blade, the katana blade is chrome plated silver as well. The finish is really nice, and if you're someone that like details and decals, then Astray is definitely for you. Astray have a lot of decals on the mobile suit. Enjoy! enjoy spending your time to put all those decals on. But seriously, back to the topic though, speaking of the value of the ASRock Red Frame, you can buy this, and I recommend you to buy this because the articulation and the movement is pretty wide, and it's pretty amazing as well. It's definitely a galloper for you to play around and then for you to take photos with. So I definitely recommend you to buy the ASRock Red Frame. Next up, the Wing Gundam EW. Yes, some like just previously from the Wing Gundam Zero EW. Yes, you can buy this because this is basically the newest Wing series that you can get. And you know, the high grade version, personally, I am a bit leaning towards not getting the high grade revived version of the Wing, because you know, if you watch my review, you know that I don't really like that Wing on that Wing Gundam Zero, because it kept flying out and it just keep dropping off from the joint. It's just really annoying. And then you know, this Wing Gundam EW right here is pretty nice, and the transformation is pretty smooth. It doesn't have that much problem like the Zeta Gundam. So yes, you can buy one and then try to enjoy it. Upcoming next is the Quanta, double Quanta. Yes, you can buy this, but as I said, the double frame problem. So if you don't know what's the double problem, you can just scroll back probably 1 minute or two to find out that problem. But anyway, let's get to the point. So double Quanta, the GN Sword 5, is that the 5? I don't really remember. So the GN Sword 5 is pretty nice. The mechanics on it is pretty nice. So you can combine it into a big sword, or you can combine it into a blast mode. I don't really remember. But the mechanics on it is pretty nice. And overall, because the galloper is not really that heavy, so you don't really see like standing problems or any kind of weapon lifting problems. So overall, the finish on the Quanta is pretty nice, and you can buy one and enjoy it. The next ROG is my heartbreaker. Why is the ROG Shinanju? Bandai, you have a perfect opportunity to get a new frame for the Shinanju, and instead you're doing the dumbest move in the whole planet by moving the Mark II frame onto the Shinanju and then just adding a couple parts and say, yeah, we create a new frame. No, the torso is really loose. And plus, Mark II don't really have a very heavy backpack. It's just a beam saber backpack and then that's it. But Shinanju have a pair of large thrusters, and it added more weight towards that torso. And as I mentioned, the Mark II torso is really loose. So adding that thruster, the Shinanju is not gonna stand well. And plus, the Shinanju have a lot of problems, such as the legs, because it's reused from the Mark II. But when they design the parts on the knees, I believe it's on the knees, there's a small piece of armor right there. They just clip on it. It's just clip it on and it's really loose. You literally just touch it a bit and then the whole piece would just fell off. So it's a massive fail, but the surface finish, I gotta tell you, is the most beautiful ROG I ever seen for a regular release. The finish is really nice on the ROG. It's better than the MG. But speaking of MG, MG do have some problem on the waist as well, especially for those tube and pipes there. MG got problems as well. ROG, the problem is the stability, and then XG, the problem is the details is not looking really that good. So my point about the Shinanju is, yes, you do want to buy it because it's pretty beautiful. The finish is absolutely stunning. But I do want to tell you that if you bought the Shinanju, once you build it and then you shoot photos, I recommend you just shove it to the shelf and never touch it again, because the stability on that Shinanju is absolutely garbage. Coming next is the Build Strike Gundam full package. Again, Strike Gundam ROG, I do not recommend you to buy it. Plus, you have the MG version for this Build Strike Gundam right here. You can get the MG version instead. And as I said, ROG Strike Gundam, no matter which version is it, the legs is going to be a huge problem. And plus, this time the Build Strike Gundam full package have a bigger rival, which means that your arms joint is gonna be worn out even quicker. So I do not recommend you to buy it. If you like this design, get the master grade, don't get the real grade. The next one on the list is the Gundam ASRock Gold Frame Amatsu Mina. Yes, you definitely want to buy this because this is possibly the second most beautiful design or the surface finish for the ROG series. The first one is Shinanju, as I just mentioned. This one right here, the frame of the ASRock is already pretty nice. And you know, adding the unique design of the Amatsumina, it looks way better. And there's a lot of articulation, I mean not a lot of articulation, a lot of accessory for you to mess around as well. And the movement is, as I said, the Astrea RG, they got really good articulation and wide movement as well, so you can pose some very crazy poses. And same with this Amatsumina right here, so definitely you can get this Scalper. Plus it looks pretty beautiful anyway, so why not? The next one is the RG Unicorn. Yes, definitely need to buy this. Why? Because I heard a lot of people who have the Master Grade, they either complain the transformation is really loose on the Master Grade Unicorn version, or you know, when you're just playing around with the AMG and then the parts will just start falling apart or automatically transform. So the RG frame is pretty tight. I even broke one of them. So, you know, as I mentioned before in the reviews, but in case you haven't watched it, so I will just say it again. When you try to assemble the arms, make sure you use the hairdryer to blow the joint on the shoulders so you can bend down. So you can bend down easier and then prevent you from snapping the arms joint, because my joints on the Banshee Nord is broken. So just giving you that tip in case you never watched the Unicorn review. The RG itself, the frame is brand new and then it also very tight. So for the poses and the stability is amazing. And then you can do a lot of poses as well because it's an RG, the articulation is gonna be great. And then the transformation process is really smooth and it's really stable. You won't have parts flying out and then or automatically transformed because the frame is not tight enough. RG Unicorn's frame is really tight and is really stable, so I definitely recommend you to get one and enjoy it. Upcoming next is the Johnny Raiden Saka 2. I reviewed this before. It was a very tragic review because nobody watches it. So put that aside. And as I said about the Saku, standing not well, articulation is horrible, and then the spraying on the legs is just absolutely a failed design, and I just don't recommend you to buy any of the ROG Saku 2. So I'm skipping this. Next, ROG Banshee Nord. Yes, because it's the same frame with the Unicorn, and I just spoke about the Unicorn's ROG, how great it is. So I already told you that ROG Unicorn, you should buy one and then enjoy it. But this is the Unicorn that I broke the arms. So yeah, go watch that review. It's pretty sad, that review. But I'm just telling you that Banshee Nord is definitely a must buy. The frame is absolutely nice. The transformation is smooth. And then you can play with the articulation and the mechanics as well. It's really nice. Definitely need to get it. ROG Torghese, another ROG that you must get because it's the new technology, a new frame, and you know, the articulation is really solid and really nice. And then the whole Gunpla stability is really nice. And I gotta tell you, the best part about the Torghese is the thrusters. The thrusters design is amazing. I mentioned it on all my Torghese video, the Torghese review, the Torghese 2, the Torghese 3 review. I shown you before the Torghese thruster design. On the Gunpla itself, the mechanics on the about the parts interacting is really nice. You have to try it. It's really nice about the ROG Torghese. Plus, the price is not that expensive. And I think the small scale Torghese, you only have those really garbage ones from the 90s. If you want those new technology ones, the ROG is your only option for small scale. And as I said, the thruster mechanics is amazing. You have to try it. Just get it. Next up is the ROG Sazabi. Again, it's a new frame, so you have to try it. The ROG Sazabi is just the Katoki Master Grade version. Just shrink it down to 1 to 144 and then, you know, come into the real grade line. It's a really nice finish. I reviewed this before. Please go check the review if you don't know the details. I reviewed this before about the Sazabi. It's pretty nice, but I gotta tell you that if you try to pose with this Sazabi, please don't use the Action Base 2. The Action Base 2 is not good enough to hold the whole Gunpla. You need to use the Action Base 5 if you want some cool poses, because the Sazabi is pretty heavy when it's finished. So I'm just telling you that don't use the Action Base 2. Action Base 5 will be better. And overall, the finish is really nice. And the stability is absolutely awesome. Until now, all the joints is still pretty tight. They never loose. I can still take it out and play with it. So yes, buy it. ROG Full Armor Unicorn. Really up to you. I'm a person that likes heavy armor, that likes a lot of weapons, but full armor unicorn just got too much weapons. Too many weapons, I'm sorry. But I don't buy it, I never review it, because I don't really like mobile suit that have too many weapons on it. I don't want to take 100 photos, okay? So that's why I never review it, because I don't want to play with that much weapons. It's too much, there's too many weapons for me. But as I said, the unicorn frame is really tight, it's really reliable, and the stability is really nice. Although this type have a lot of things at the back, but you don't really have like a problem where the unicorn cannot really, the joint will become very loose or something like that. You don't really have that problem. So yes, I would recommend you to buy it. Plus, the AMG version or the full armor unicorn, don't get it, is the parts will just fall all over the place and the weapons don't really hold well. So master grade version, I would not recommend you, but real grade version, yes. I'm running out of breath. I might have to split this video in half. So next one is the Crossbone Gundam X1. The X1 is a very nice finish, although I haven't bought it because I'm pretty tired. Because why? I bought the whole set for the high grade Universal Century, and I honestly don't really have that kind of passion to buy another ROG set again. So that's why I'm still kind of holding back. I don't want to buy it. So until my mind is fixed up, and then until my mind is ready, I will not build another ROG. I will not get the ROG Crossbone because I don't want to buy the whole series again. But speaking of the small scale Crossbone X1, it's really nice. The stability is really nice. Basically, from now on, all the ROG stability is pretty nice because they improved the technology. They are not using pre-made frames. Instead, you have to assemble the frames yourself, like the Master Grade. So the Crossbone X1 is pretty nice to finish. They even give you like the targeting eye patch on the head. It's pretty nice. And the anti-beam clock is actually usable now, because if you watch my high grade reviews, those clock right there, they cannot be used. When you're trying to equip on it, it's impossible. The ROG, they have special design, the special joint for it. So now you can post with it very freely. So yes, ROG Crossbone, you can get it. The second last one is the new Gundam. New Gundam rules will be like this. If you will put out your new Gundam for presentation, or you will pose with it, buy the new Gundam theme funnel effect set. If you're just gonna build it and then put it back to the shelf, then just get the regular new Gundam without the effect parts. That's basically how you rank it. But I do want to say that this one right here, just like the Zazabi, I think it's based on the Katoki version from the Master Grade, but the real grade is better than the Master Grade, especially at the funnels. The Master Grade funnels only got one very small plastic clip for you to clip all the funnels together, and it's really easy to break because it's soft. For the real grade, they gave you two pieces to snap the funnels together. So even if you shake the funnels on the new Gundam, they're not gonna fall apart. So it's pretty nice. The stability is absolutely amazing. The articulation is amazing as well. I already reviewed that. So if you don't know the articulation or the details, watch my ROG New Gundam review. It's really nice. You have to buy one and try it. The last one about the regular release is the Force Impulse Gundam. I haven't bought it yet because I just like the same reason like the X1. I bought the whole HGCE set and now they came out with an ROG. I feel like it's a big slap on my face. So I kind of have some hard feelings and I don't really want to buy the real grade yet. I just want to calm my mind first. So I'm not going to buy that real grade first. So real grade Impulse, yes, you need to buy that because it's a brand new frame. Basically from now on, all the ROG, you should get it because they are basically new. So this one right here, I will tell you, you can get it, but I'm not going to be reviewing it until I get over it from that high grade series, because I bought the whole set for high grade and it hurts now to see real grade coming out. But anyway, I still recommend you to buy this real grade because as I said, it's brand new. And so far from what I see from the community, the reaction is pretty nice. Everyone was pretty impressed about the design and the articulation and the stability and the mechanics and the gimmicks. So I think that you can give it a try. It's just, Maybe next time when you can watch my Impulse review will be like 1 year, 2 years later.